So we're here at the Greensboro Coliseum in Greensboro.
Hey, they did come. We followed you guys. We were behind you the whole way here. We have the bumper stickers. That's awesome.
So yeah, we're here and there's a lot of Bernie bumper stickers. And equal rights. So this is the one place where my Karl Marx shirt will not get me in trouble.
Ah, so exciting.
Oh, women's places in the White House. That's a little weird, but all right.
On for this Bernie Sanders rally.
Woohoo! So, we'll have to see. I mean, it's 4:42 right now. The doors don't open until 6, so we're just gonna wait and see.
Alright, you're just putting it right, right here. Oops for Bernie.
They just interviewed her to be on local television.
Oh my god, it's so awesome.
I think he liked the line above the buttons.
It's all about strategic placement.
So, what do you say, news 2?
News 2.
You know, why come here just to sit on the sidelines? Let's be close.
Thank you. which makes the establishment nervous is the way campaigns are run today, is the candidates hold these little dinners and little parties for their super PACs, and they're in. $3 million or $5 million. I am proud to tell you that this campaign does not and will not have a super PAC. I don't want their money. We're doing is kind of an experiment never done before, and that is we are relying on small individual contributions, and up to now we've gotten over 400,000 contributions averaging $31.20. Many of whom are working longer hours, lower wages, demanding an economy that works for all of us, and not just for them. I am often asked by the media or the political pundits, and they say, you know, Bernie, how does it happen that you're drawing crowds like this? How does it happen that so many young people coming out? I thought young people were alienated. Why is it that so many working class people are coming out? And the answer is pretty simple, that in the year 2015, the American people are sick and tired of establishment politics. They are sick and tired of establishment economics. And they want real change in this country. Are you nuts? Why do you go to a political rally? It's a beautiful evening. Why are you wasting your time listening to a guy from a state that no one has ever even heard of? By the way, I invite you all to come up to my house. Here is the point. We have got to change public consciousness and political consciousness in this country. Your friends, your family have got to know that at a time when the Koch brothers are spending $900 million to buy this election for the wealthy and the powerful, obviously politics matters. It matters for your future, for the future of your kids, for the future of your parents. So anybody who tells you that politics doesn't matter, you ask them why the Koch brothers are spending $900 million. They know it matters. We know it. On some of the issues that are in my heart, and I think in many of your hearts, in terms of what is going on in America. Let me begin with an issue that I think is one of the most significant moral issues of our time, one of the most significant economic and political issues of our time, and that is the grotesque level of income and wealth inequality that we're seeing. The United States of America has more income and wealth inequality than any other major country on earth, and it is worse today than at any time since 1928. There is something profoundly wrong when the top 1/10 of 1%, not 1%, 1/10 of 1% owns almost as much wealth as the bottom 90%. Now, all over this country, there are people working awfully hard. They're working 50, 60 hours a week, 2 or 3 jobs. But 58% of all new income being created is going to the top 1%. Now, my Republican colleagues get very nervous when we talk about redistribution of wealth. But what all of you should know and must know is there has been, in the last 30 years, a massive redistribution of wealth in this country.
Yeah.
The problem is, it has gone in the wrong direction. What we have seen over the last 30 years are trillions of dollars leaving the pockets of working families and ending up in the bank accounts of the top 1/10 of 1%. Brothers and sisters, this issue of income inequality will no longer be swept under the rug. Together, we are going to deal with it. Is sending a very simple and straightforward message to the billionaire class.
Right.
And that message is, you cannot have it all.
Woo!
That is not what this country is supposed to be about. You are not going to get more tax breaks at the same time as children in America go hungry. Compensation packages to the CEOs at the same time as you cut wages and pensions and health care benefits. The greed, the unquenchable greed of corporate America is destroying this country. The economy today is in much better shape than it was 7 years ago when Bush left office. office, we were hemorrhaging 800,000 jobs a month. But while the economy is better today than it was then, what we also have to acknowledge is that for the last 40 years, the middle class of this country, once the envy of the entire world, that middle class continues to disappear. And what that means is that today, median family income is almost $5,000 less than it was in 1999. What it means is that in inflation accounted for dollars, the male worker right in the middle of the economy is earning $700 less in real dollars than he earned 42 years ago. And that woman worker in the middle of the economy, she is earning $1,500 less than she did. That in your state, here in North Carolina, in my state, all over this country, people are not working one job, they're working two jobs, and they're working three jobs to cobble together some income and some health care. Yeah. That is not the economy we need. Now, when we talk about the economy, obviously we have to talk about levels of unemployment. Let me tell you something that some of you know, some of you may not know. Every month the government comes out with some statistics on unemployment. And the official unemployment rate this month is 5.1%. But there is another government statistic that comes out which calculates those people who are unemployed and who have given up looking for work and who are working part-time when they want to work full-time. And when you add all of that together, real unemployment is over 10%. Oh! One of the fun things about running for president is you can try to force discussion on issues which the establishment chooses not to talk about. Important issues. A month ago, I asked an economic think tank to do a study with me. And what I said is, tell me what the real unemployment rate is for high school graduates between the age of 17 and 20. That was the question. And this is what they came back to. For white kids, who are high school graduates between 17 and 20, real unemployment is 33%. For Hispanic kids, 36%. For African American kids, 51%. In other words, what we are doing is turning our backs on an entire generation of young people. What do young people want to do? What they want to do is when they're out of high school, they'd like to get a job, like to get their own apartment, they'd like to earn some money, they'd like to start a career, they would like to get their feet on the ground and become independent. Today, there are 5.5 million young people who are hanging out on street corners here in North Carolina and all over this country, no jobs, no education. And let me tell you something else. There's a study done a few years ago. This is really tragic, but it is important to put these issues on the table because if we don't discuss them, we can't solve them. Now here is this. Now this is, listen to this. 2009, the last study that we have seen, 69% of African American young people who drop out of high school ended up in jail. Now I want you all to think about the tragedy of what that means. And to my mind, the conclusion that any sensible person reaches is that what we have got to do as a nation is invest in education and jobs.